Hi guys, today I have the perfect summer DIY for you. Now that it's finally summer, it's time to break out your summer shorts, and I'm gonna show you how to create your own pair of high-waisted distressed shorts in just a few steps. So here's what you'll need. You'll need a pair of high-waisted jeans, and I suggest using old jeans or thrifted jeans. There's tons of high-waisted jeans at the thrift stores. You'll also need some sandpaper for distressing, and you can find this at any craft store. And you'll also need a hard surface or a straight edge, also for distressing, and I'm just using a book. You can use anything. And finally, you'll need a pair of sharp scissors for cutting. And these are the jeans that I'll be using today. These are just high-waisted jeans I thrifted for $3.99. If you don't have any high-waisted jeans, you can just use your regular old jeans. To start, you're going to lay your jeans down on a flat surface and determine where you want to cut them. I'm going to be using another pair of shorts as a guide for how short I want mine to be, but you can always cut them however short you want. Just be sure to leave about an inch or so just in case you need to fix the length, because you can always go back and cut more off later. The important thing to remember when you're cutting your shorts is to leave enough crotch space so they fit correctly. I would say leave about 3 to 4 inches. Now you're going to mark where you want to cut your jeans, and I'm doing it the lazy way and I'm just going to fold where I'll be cutting. But again, I suggest leaving about an inch or so just in case you need to fix any mistakes later on. You're gonna want to make sure that both sides are even in length, and you can do so by folding the jeans together to make sure that they line up. Another tip is to pin down the crotch area so it doesn't move around when you're cutting, because denim can be a little bit difficult to cut. So this is where a really sharp pair of fabric shears is going to be really important, because it'll help you cut more easily. But don't worry too much, because it doesn't have to come out perfectly straight. So now that you've cut your jeans into shorts, you can make sure that they are the right length that you want and that they measure up. And if not, you can just go ahead and go back in and cut to the right length. After making any other adjustments, you want to try them on really quick and make sure that the length is good on your body. And you can actually stop here if you don't want to distress them, and you can leave them like this. But I'm going to show you guys how you can create your own distressed shorts with sandpaper. So here is where you'll need your straight edge and your sandpaper. Actually, a cutting board would work really, really well for this. So taking your straight edge, again, I'm just using a book, place it on the inside of your shorts where you want your hole to be. And now you're going to fold your jeans over the edge, and you're gonna take your sandpaper and you're just gonna start to rub it against the denim until you can start to see a distress line. This is going to take a little bit of time, so just be patient, and it's also going to be a bit of a mess, so make sure you're doing this somewhere you can easily clean up. After a little bit, you're going to see where that line is, and it's going to start making a hole, and it's going to make it really easy to rip the denim, and I think it makes a really cool kind of distressed look, and then you can start pulling apart the threads in the denim. You can actually make the hole even bigger, and all you have to do is continue making little slits with the sandpaper, and I'm just gonna move the book down just a little bit, probably a centimeter or so, and make another distressed line with the sandpaper. And again, once you start to see the hole and the line form, you can just go ahead and rip the denim and pull apart the thread. So if you look really closely at your jeans, there are actually blue and white threads. So right here, I'm just separating the blue and white threads, and I'm actually going to take a pair of pliers. You can use tweezers or anything you find to help you separate those white threads from the blue threads, and you're gonna wanna keep the white ones. So carefully just pull apart the white threads from the blue ones, and you'll get the hang of it, and it'll become really easy to do. Again, this will take a bit of patience, but like I said, once you get the hang of it, it'll be really easy and you'll do this pretty quickly. And after a while, your fingers are gonna wanna scream in pain, so I highly suggest using some pliers or any kind of tools that'll help your fingers out. Another tip to help make distressing your shorts a lot easier is if you turn your shorts inside out after you make your slit. You can actually see the white threads a lot easier this way, and then you can take your pliers or whatever tool you're using to separate the threads this way. I think it's a lot easier just because you can see it better. So here you have your first finished hole, and you can keep making the hole bigger just by repeating the same steps as before, and you can put holes in different areas. You can make them bigger or smaller if you want. I'm just gonna keep putting some random holes everywhere on the shorts to finish up the look. So after a little while of distressing, your shorts should look something like this. And if you're happy with the look, just chuck them in the wash and they will become even more distressed, especially at the hem. And you can help it along by just pulling apart at the white threads. But just remember, the more you wear and wash them, the more the holes and the hem will become frayed. I hope you guys enjoyed this easy summer DIY, and I really want to see your recreations. If you try this out, you can always find me at the links below, and remember to like and subscribe if you want to see more, and I will talk to you guys later. Bye!